Water connects everything we do in life, but too often it's overlooked or taken for granted. In the next 10 years, over half the world's population is expected to be living in areas affected by water scarcity. And climate change is only making that worse. The good news is that there are many solutions out there that can help us address these water challenges. All right, so all this is just going all the time is, so okay. I'm Will Hughes, and I'm the Water Sustainability Lead at Amazon Web Services. I was originally attracted to water because I saw a lot of opportunity to bring solutions to those water challenges. And a company like AWS can bring its core competence to help solve them too. AWS is committing to be water positive by 2030. That means we'll return more water to communities and the environment than we use in our operations. We'll meet the water positive goal in two different ways. We're working with nonprofit partners around the world to invest in projects that increase water availability in the communities where we operate. Second, we're working within our data centers to implement innovative solutions that help us improve water efficiency and reduce our water use.
Ideally, we don't want to use any water. That's what I'm after. Like, I want to solve that. I'm Therese Soundaraj, and I'm a principal mechanical engineer at AWS. My job here is to design the most efficient cooling systems for our data centers. We only use water for cooling when we absolutely need to. So when we can, we take advantage of the weather. During cooler months, the outside air is directly pulled into our server rooms to keep our hardware at a safe operating temperature. But this doesn't work when it's very hot outside, especially during summer months. So that's when we need to use water for cooling. During hotter months, we use an evaporative cooling system, which pulls in outside air and forces it through water-soaked cooling pads. The water evaporates, reducing the air's temperature, and the cool air is then directly supplied into the server rooms. To fine-tune our cooling operation, we install sensors that track the weather parameters like temperature and humidity. As soon as the conditions drop to a safe operating range, the evaporative cooling system shuts off and cool air is directly supplied into the server rooms. We're continuously innovating and improving our cooling system so that it's the most sustainable and efficient option out there.
In the past, we used drinkable water for cooling, but we've started looking for more sustainable options.
I'm Chris Lee, and I'm a facility manager at AWS. I'm a Bay Area native and an avid fisherman, so I spend a lot of time on the water. Throughout the years living in the Bay Area, I've seen the water levels in these lakes and reservoirs go down significantly. Water scarcity is a real challenge across California, which is not only why we're reducing the amount of water we use, but changing the type of water we use for cooling. AWS has data centers located in the city of Santa Clara, which has a system of piping that delivers recycled water to their customers. The water that nobody really wants, it just goes down the drain. It goes through a chemical treatment plant, and we get to see the benefits of reusing it again. It saves us from using the water in these lakes and reservoirs. And in California, every drop counts, specifically if you're a fisherman.
In Umatilla, Oregon, where some of our data centers are located, farming is at the heart of the community. To help support the local economy and reduce our water footprint, we created a way to help farmers reuse our cooling water for irrigation. I'm Kelly Galway, and I'm a Water Resources Data Manager at AWS. At our Oregon data centers, 96% of our spent cooling water is used for irrigating crops like corn, wheat, and soybeans. To make sure the water is safe enough for irrigation, we installed sensors that monitor water quality. The sensors continuously collect data, and AWS IoT gateways transmit the data to the cloud for analysis and automated alarming. If there are any water quality issues, we're instantly alerted.
What is an IoT gateway?
Great question. IoT stands for Internet of Things, and IoT gateway means it's a computer that can send data to the cloud without being connected to Wi-Fi or any kind of local internet. We've leveraged the power of the AWS cloud, offering a secure solution to collect data and scale the program very easily going forward. Do you want to do it again? Claire will be better, I promise.
I'm Claire Biddle, and I'm a resource Water resource. I'm Claire Biddle, and I'm a water resource manager at AWS. Returning water back to the environment is a huge part of us becoming water positive. In the United Kingdom, we're working with the charity The Rivers Trust and local trust Action for the River Kennet to create two wetlands on the tributary of the River Thames. This is one of London's main sources of drinkable water, but drought and pollution are threatening the region's long-term water security. The creation of wetlands will help with this because they act as natural filtration systems. The plants within the wetlands slow the water flow, which remove nutrients and sediments. The wetlands will also help recharge local groundwater, which makes the area more resilient to drought. AWS is already investing in nature-based solutions around the world. Each one of these projects is delivering improved water quality and availability for the surrounding communities.
I'm hopeful because we're seeing more innovation in the water sector than we've ever seen before. We're seeing new technologies that can fundamentally change how we address these water challenges. And AWS is excited to be part of driving those innovations forward. We have industry-leading water efficiency, and 20 of our data centers are using sustainable recycled water. And we've supported projects that have brought clean water and sanitation services to nearly 300,000 people in India and Indonesia. We're also working to reach net zero carbon emissions by 2040 as part of the Climate Pledge, which Amazon committed to in 2019. And with each change, we're making a more sustainable future for our company and our customers. But most importantly, we're making a better future for our planet.